Character texturing is very simple in Blender. In this video, I'll share the character texturing process that I use to create good looking skin shading inside of Blender. We'll be going over two topics in this video: how you can easily texture paint your characters, and how you can use procedural shading to enhance your skin textures. So if that's something you're interested in, let's get started. So to get started with texture painting, I'm going to be using the Vertex Paint mode. And I'm using the Vertex Paint mode so that I don't have to create UV maps for these characters. We can always bake the Vertex colors to the texture map if we need to, but just for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to be using the Vertex Paint mode. So here in the Vertex Paint, we're going to start texturing the character. So under here in my color palettes, I already have some colors I've chosen, so I'll just start texturing. I'm going to increase my brush strength, and I can actually press Ctrl X to just fill in everything. I'm going to select a darker shade of my skin tone. I'm just going to paint around the eye. I'll reduce the strength of the brush and I'll just paint over this lower eyelid. Just like that. And I'm going to reduce the strength of my brush, increase the size of the brush, and I'll just paint over the upper eyelid and smooth everything out while holding down shift, something like that. And I'm going to choose from here, I'm just going to choose a red color. And I'll paint over the upper eyelid. I'm going to paint over the upper eyelid. And then we're going to paint some reds around the nose, the cheeks, and the ears. I'm going to start out with the ears. I'm just going to paint over all of this like this. And then I'll paint some reds around the cheeks, just like so. And I'll hold down shift and smooth out everything. And I'll do the same around the nose. And now I think the red on the nose is actually too much, so I'll just switch back to my default skin color. I'll reduce the brush strength a little bit, and I'm just going to paint over that part of the nose so that we can tone down the red on the nose. Yeah, something like that seems fine. Maybe I'll also do the same for the cheek. And I'll just smooth out everything. Now we can paint in the lips. I'm going to select the skin tone from here. I'm just going to paint over the lips and I'll smooth out everything, and I don't want the lower lip to be this dark, so I'm going to paint over it with a red color. And now you can see that I'm affecting both the upper lip, and I don't want to do that, so I'll just go into edit mode and I'll select this loop around here. I'll hide this, use L on the keyboard to select link. I'll just select link C. I'll unhide mesh and I'll go back to Vertex Paint mode. To isolate only those meshes that we selected in the edit mode, I can come over here to the paint marks tool. I'll just select that, and now we isolate only those parts that we selected in the edit mode. So I'll turn off my overlays from here, and now I can just paint only directly on that, on the lower lip without affecting the upper lip, and something like that seems fine. And I can turn this off now. I'll add in some reds under the chin and I'll smooth out everything. Now with this basic skin texturing, we can actually go ahead and start the procedural shading. I'm going to split my viewport here and I'm going to select the character model, and I'm going to just add in a new material. I'll name this skin and I'll go into the rendered view. I'll just hide the hair and the some other stuff so that we can focus only on the face. And now we want to add in the color attribute that we just painted. That's the Vertex color that we just painted. It's right over here. It's a color attribute. I'm just going to rename this to skin color map. And now to add in that color attribute, we are just going to search here for color attributes. And from the drop down, we can select the skin color map. I'm going to plug in the skin color map to the base color. And now we can already see that we have the color map that we painted in the rendered view. But we can improve the texture a bit more from here. And to do that, we are going to start with the ambient occlusion node. I'm going to search for the ambient occlusion node. I have the node wrangler add-on enabled, so I can press Ctrl Shift left click on the ambient occlusion to preview this node. And I'm just going to add in a color ramp and drop it in between here. I'm going to drag in this black position so that we can see the effect of the color ramp a bit. And now we can see the effect of the color ramp around the eyes, around the ears, and the nostrils. That's fine. And now we want to add in another node. This one is called the geometry node. And in this geometry node, we need this pointiness socket. So I'm just going to plug that into a color RAM, and we are going to drag this black slider. Okay, I'm actually going to preview this color RAM node. I'm just going to drag in the black slider this way. I bring in the white, something like this. That looks fine. And now we want to mix in the ambient occlusion with the geometry node. We're going to do that with a mix color node. I'm just going to drop this one here. I'll impute the geometry into the B socket and the color ramp into the E socket. And now we can change the blending mode to multiply. And we will take this up by 0.8. And now we want to mix in our color attribute with all of this that we have just done. So we are going to duplicate this multiply node once again. And I'm going to put this one in the B socket. Our skin color map, I'm going to plug that into the A socket. And we can already see the difference that that has made. If I preview the color attribute node, this is what we had before. And now with the ambient occlusion and pointiness node added, this is what we have. Maybe I'll just increase this to 1. And now there's something we want to actually adjust over here. You can notice all these black details over here. Instead of it being black, we can make it red just to indicate some fleshiness on the skin. So we are going to come over here and just change this to a red value. And I'll copy this one and just paste it. And now instead of it being black, it is actually now red. So it just gives, you know, a little bit, it just looks a little bit more like skin. And now we want to add more skin variation or more color variation to the skin. And we are going to do that with a noise texture. I'm going to add in a noise texture and Ctrl T to add in the texture coordinates and mapping node. And I'm going to plug in the object into the mapping node, and I'll preview this new texture. I'll add in a color ramp in front of the noise texture, and I'll just increase the scale of this noise texture so that we can see the effect. I'll take this to about 100, and now I can crunch in the black value, something like that. And I'll increase the scale to about 10. I'll increase the distortion to 0.1. And now I want to use this black and white marks to control or to add some color variation to the skin texture. I'll duplicate this multiply node again. I'm going to plug the color map into the A socket, and I'm going to plug in this noise texture into the factor. And now I'm going to preview this. And if I zoom in here, we can see the effect of the noise texture. I'm going to take back the black slider a little bit more so that we can see that effect a bit more. And now we can actually see it coming through on the skin. I think for here, 0.6 will be fine. And that's okay for now. And now we want to also use this same noise texture setup to control the bump of the skin. I'm going to select this color ramp and Ctrl Shift D to duplicate the color ramp without disconnecting this, and we're going to use this to control the bump. So I'm just going to add in a bump node here, and I'm going to preview this, and we can see how it will look once we plug it into the principal BRDF. I'm going to reduce the black slider, I'll take it down a bit, and I'm also going to reduce the strength of the bump texture of the bump node about 0.08 should be fine. Yeah, something like that. And I'm going to plug this bump texture right in the normal texture. I'll just arrange here a little bit. I'll preview the principal BSDF. Actually, I'll plug this one into the principal BSDF. And now we can see the effect of the bump on the skin. Maybe it's a little bit too much. The noise texture is too big, so I'll just increase it from here once again to about 130. And yeah, that's looking fine. So now we want to control the specularity of the principal BSDF. We're also going to do that with this same noise texture setup. I'm going to Ctrl Shift D on this color ramp, and under the specular of the principal BSDF, I'm just going to plug in this color ramp right into the IOR level. And if we crunch in the black values, we can actually see the effect that the specularity will have on the skin, but this is not what we want. I'm just going to take this back down to about 0.1, and that seems okay for now. Now we are going to add more color variation to the skin, and we are going to do that using a Voronoi texture. I'm going to add in a Voronoi texture and Ctrl T to add the texture coordinate and mapping node. And I'm going to connect the object into the vector, and I'm just going to preview this Voronoi texture. I'm going to increase the scale to about 100, and then instead of F1, we are going to use smooth F1, and I'll add in a color ramp before the Voronoi texture. And I'm just going to flip the color ramp. I'm going to bring in these black values in like this. And now this white spot on the skin will have a different color from our main skin color map. And we will see that once we add this into the texture. I'm just going to adjust this node. And now I'm going to duplicate this, plug that here. And now I'm going to use this runner texture and plug it into the factor. And if I preview this node, we can see the effect that has. But I think this is a bit too much. So I'll just come over here to the scale, and I'll adjust this to, I think, 3 or maybe 1.5. We okay? Yeah, something like that seems fine. I'm going to plug in the color attributes. We want this multiply node to use our color map that we made. So I'm just going to plug this in here. And yeah, that seems fine. If you want to reduce the effect of the color variation, we're just going to come here, and this white are going to change the value to about, let's say, 0.7, or you can even reduce this further to 0.6. All right, and that seems fine. And if you plug this final one into principled BSDF and we preview that, we are going to see that we already have something that looks really nice. And to go further, we want to add some freckles around the cheek. So to do this, we have to go back to solid mode, and we'll just make a new vertex color, because now we want to paint in where the freckles will be on the skin. So I want to add in a new color, and I'll just name this skin freckles, and I'll change the color here to white. Now click OK. And now we'll go back to vertex paint mode, and I'm just going to select a black color. And we want the freckles to be everywhere around here. Something like this. I'm just going to smooth out all of this. And now we want freckles around this part of the face. So we will go back to shading. I'm going to go back to my rendered mode. And then I'm going to duplicate this color attribute. And we're going to select the skin freckles. And I'll just preview that with Ctrl Shift left click. And now we are going to duplicate this runner texture. And I'll duplicate this multiply node. And now I'll plug in the color attribute into the A socket and the runner texture into the factor. And let's preview that. It will plug this into the B socket. You can see the effect, but we want to increase this a little bit more. I'm actually just going to invert this, and now we can see that we are going to have freckles on this part of the face. And I think I want to increase the scale of this. I'll increase this to about 3, and that seems fine. And now we are going to add in those freckles with another multiply node. I'll just duplicate this and keep that here, and I'll plug this into the factor of this. And I'm going to preview this node, and I'll set this to black. And now we can start to see the effects coming through a little bit on the skin. We can see that we have more freckles here than other parts of the character. I'm going to actually go back to the color ramp. I'll increase the value of this. I'll just take it all the way to 1. And instead of using black here, I'll just plug in our main skin color map into that multiply node. Now we can see the effect that has, and that's all that we're going to do for the color variation. We can come back to the principal BSDF, and we're going to turn on the subsurface scattering, and that will be the final touch for the skin shader. And we can come down here to the subsurface scattering. Now we're going to change this to random walk skin, and then we'll put the weight to about 0.3. Or let me just show you something at 0.7. We can see that like the ear turns white, and you know, some things are turning white, and that's not really what we want. So to fix that, we are going to just reduce the scale to about 0.01. Now we can see that the ears are actually like red as it would be when we have subsurface. If we have just take this to about 0.08, and yeah, that seems fine. And this is the final node setup. You can actually download this from my Gumroad if you want to. And yeah, catch you guys in the next one.